Peter Dutton was accused of being racist during the week after he suggested we shouldn't be taking in anyone from Gaza unless thorough background checks can be guaranteed. Now, this morning, Labor frontbencher Ed Husic told Sky News that he believes Mr. Dutton made the call for a ban impulsively.
I mean, this is just Peter Dutton playing semantics and trying to dodge the fact that he made a call on a morning TV program without thinking it through. This is a person who wants to be Prime Minister. You can't make those calls in that way without thinking stuff through.
During the interview, Mr. Husic said Labor had deliberately chosen to give the new Palestinian arrivals visitor visas because they were faster to process than refugee visas. Joe, isn't that exactly what Peter Dutton is concerned about here?
Yeah, I can certainly understand why there would be concerns about people coming from a very sort of highly charged ideological war zone, and I can certainly understand why Peter Dutton thinks that this is the sort of thing that will play well among a lot of voters. Obviously, I would like to see, you know, the most thorough security vetting possible for any of these refugees, but I do think you have to also look at the reality of the situation. When, if it is your purpose to stop these people from being killed, and you need to get them out of there, and you need to get them out of there in a timely fashion, and it highlights, I suppose, the fact that other bordering countries are not allowing them into third-party refugee camps for, you know, a proper temporary resettlement, and so all those security checks can be processed. So this is, you know, an indictment on Jordan and Egypt and the usual suspects.
Yeah,
so,
all the neighbouring Arab countries.
Who care so much, that's right, who care so much but won't take them.
Yeah.
But again, I think
there's context.
I'm a pragmatist at heart, and I think that, you know, if, you know, you have to, you know, if your priority is these people need to get out, they've got contacts with Australia or, you know, links to Australia, we need to get them out and we have to do all the security vetting we possibly can. But
security vetting that takes an hour in some cases, the government has admitted.
You know,
and on average, 24 hours. It isn't. And Joe just said that he's making a play for voters. I mean, that suggests that this is about base politics. I don't think so. I think this is a national security issue here.
I would agree. I like to look at it as this. Think of it like this. If I'm at home alone, or any of us women are at home alone with our children, and in the middle of the night, and we get a knock on the door, and there's a man there, a stranger, someone that we do not know, they look dishevelled, they're asking for help. What's the appropriate thing I'm going to do? You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to shut the door. I'm going to call for help, but under no circumstance am I going to let that man into my home and put my children or myself in a vulnerable position. I like to think of what's happening.
What if it's a woman and a child, though?
Absolutely not. I don't know who they are. There are plenty of women out there who commit crimes. It's the same thing. If there's a stranger that I do not know, I'm not letting them in our home. Australia is our home. We don't have the capability to investigate thoroughly or properly whether these particular people coming into our country pose a threat to our own children and our own nation. And I think the biggest question here is, why are the Arab nations not taking them? Are they a threat?
My mum.
Are they deemed to be a problem? What's the reason?
You just tried to interject there. I mean, do you really think that the proper national security checks can be made in as little as 24 hours?
People coming from a
terrorist enclave.
Sure. So they're our national security checks on top of cooperation with a vast array of other international, Germany, Israel. There's a network of information and dossiers being built up on these people. There are lists being compiled. It's not like you just get someone a clean sheet of paper across your door and say, oh, I'll interview you for an hour and then I'll let you in. Of course that's not what happens. Of course that's
not. How do they have the means,
And Peter Dutton knows this. And you see, in your introduction, and I'd be happy for someone to say that I'm wrong, and I sincerely hope I am wrong, but I understood that Peter Dutton originally called for a blanket ban. Mm. A blanket ban. And subsequently he's dug up by saying, oh, well, we can have a blanket ban, but actually maybe we can only have a blanket ban unless you do these security checks in place.
The first thing he said was that there should be a ban on people from this area.
That's correct. Right. Which
but,
what, which
but
is
that was on the
he,
basis
which
that
is the
those thorough checks
did not,
are not happening.
That, that
in
is a standard
place.
On which he himself did not pursue when he was immigration minister from other war zones with other similar bad actors in that region.
Okay.